Good evening. Getting into some more VR. It's Maskmaker. If you're watching this on Twitch, please, as a VOD, please think about following. If you're watching this on YouTube, please like and subscribe, and maybe also consider checking out the Twitch channel and giving me a follow. Okay, let's move this back a bit. Okay, so I made a blue mask.
Mask is an imprint of the mind, of the emotions. Wear it, and it disguises you with truth. So, you passed the chasm. I'm reasonably impressed. You have potential indeed. I'll have to keep an eye on you.
Pinching my hair. Okay, if you're watching earlier, sorry about the rush offline. I was having some stomach issues, so really had to go. Can I not? Nope, okay.
The fine mask marks this one as a tower guardian. They hold no power since the towers went dark, but once they were spread throughout the realm, and always wore the most intricate masks. Crude things to a mask maker's eye, of course. Here the weavers and the shepherds would trade their goods with the miners from deep below, but the cave mouth has been blocked for a long time. This village used to be full with movement, life, and birdsong, but now, silence. Perhaps they too needed purpose. Breathe it in. These are the highest, but also the deepest places in my realm. We'll get to that. This was a weaver who could trade their goods for pearls from other lands. You shall have to find components from elsewhere in the realm. A six-headed stormberry. Well done. It's not easy to find. Usually we only find two or three heads. That's like a four-leaf clover times three.
Is that not it?
A mask is a performance, and it expects you to play along. You must know what your mask needs you to be.
Those little bloody balls. Thank you.
There have been great civilizations that rose without the wheel, but all cultures find ways to mask their members.
Lost the fungicide bottle? Don't worry, there should be another back where you first mixed the potion.
Honor my posture. Love thyself, but deny vanity. Follow my gestures. Come to the tower. Your power is growing.
Was this one a gatherer too? I don't remember anymore. My poor loyal subjects.
I think the penalty.
It's time to expand your mask making. The masks always did not.
Tells me where to get things.
Thank you. bloody pearls.
Where do I get the bells?
Honor, I posture. Be open, be tolerant, and defy isolation.
I should have done rock all that way. How am I supposed to find these pearls? Surely it's here somewhere. Thank you. Where's the
Good. What a magnificent white glass pearl. Another component found. This is...
That took way too long to find.
Brackish but surprisingly edible sun kelp. Used in fertility rites, believe it or not. This part of my realm has seen better days. Once my subjects kept every corner, spick and span, but they were always moving, always changing beneath my hands. I only needed them to be still a moment, so I could work. Now, oh, the realm's so quiet, but at least things stay where I put them. The town guard. If I remember rightly, this village is known for having magnificent sea grove charms to avoid storms and give thanks for blessings from the sea. All right.
ran away. I was trying my luck shoe-shining on the streets. But the poor folk were too poor, and the rich too clean. One day a family passed, all dressed in furs and silks, and beneath the fancy cloaks, mud-soaked shoes. But when I called out to them to offer them a shine, they drubbed me for my trouble. A fine sea growth coral. Rather wasted in this simple cottage, wouldn't you say? It would look perfect on one of my dozen mantelpieces.
You will find answers at the tower.
This is the guardian of the archipelago tower. How did he get to this side of the island? Did you know about this? The last one, guardian of my tower, guardian of the archipelago. Being a mask maker is not about making masks for yourself, believe me, apprentice. But by making masks for others, you can find their truths, and perhaps catch a glimpse of some of your own. Here the people crafted fishing boats, and the legends say even larger vessels to explore beyond the horizon. Legends, of course. These people aren't as incapable of exploration. Not without a king. Well, a boat is a useful thing, I suppose, but there's been no wind here. What's that sound? Where is that wind coming from? I've not felt it stir since I don't know when. Truly, the realm is responding to your touch, my apprentice. It draws me to the towers. Perhaps the kingdom senses my great design and urges you forward to find all three ancient fragments. But don't forget, you're in my realm. Yes, I know all about the whispering voices trapped in the towers. I can't stop you hearing them, but perhaps it suits me for now. Do you hear me, ancient ghosts? My realm! I took this kingdom from you once, and I will do it again.
Yeah, yeah.
You, apprentice, do not forget that we have a deal.
What deal? I'm kind of this dude's jib. Okay.
I am weakened. And it is too early for you. Meet my siblings. They will help you restore my power. At least that's an elder's statue in its right condition.
Cross da Thank you.
follow my gesture.
Honor my posture, know thyself. Follow my gestures. Fight against oblivion. You will find answers at the tower.
Follow my gestures and find me. My tower is close.
What was that? Oh, the statue is awake.
Honor my posture. Know thyself. Follow my gestures. Fight against oblivion. You will find answers at the tower.
Any ideas? I got nothing.
Like, is this the last statue or is it somewhere else?
Masks are simple. They express their emotions directly, unlike humans.
It is not you who creates the mask, but the mask who creates you.
Hmm.
remember, you do not bring the mask to your face. You put yourself into the mask.
Oh.
I give up. How am I supposed to pose? Oh, don't tell me it crashed.
Phragmites Australis. Don't be fooled. This humble reed, basis of many great designs, is also one of the most invasive and aggressive plants in the realm. Go back to where you first made the fungicide. There will be more.
A beautiful design, refined by centuries of wisdom and knowledge of the swamp. Oh, so much has been lost. A mask cannot be owned, only borrowed, which, frankly, is very bad for business.
Look how it has sucked the life from this tree.
Follow my gestures and come to the tower. Find the truth.
Lost the fungicide bottle? Don't worry, there should be another back where you first mixed the potion. There's one less fungus. A good start. Oh, wait, wait. The spores are regrowing. The most precious ingredient the swamp has to offer, this fragile lily crown flower. It seems that such beauty can only thrive here in this hostile environment.
This was a guardian of the swamps before the corruption took hold. See its mask? This is the pinnacle of the mask maker's art.
Just as a mask has an inner and outer face, it can disguise you from others, but beware also from yourself.
The mask maker does not create the design. They see it in the world, in the face of the customer.
That blasted tower. When I first came to this realm, there was a power here already. Old and frightened, it clung to the past, it clung to its power, and refused to share. I am unable to enter these towers. But then, well, that's what apprentices are for.
The king's story is incomplete. Come to the tower.
Good. The tower allows you in. Faithful apprentice, once in there, I cannot follow.
It is good to see you again. The so-called king has his apprentice, eh? Remember, you are wearing other faces, but your path is your own to choose. Already you can tell that all is not what it seems, right? I can't promise you will like what I have to show you, apprentice. But I will not lie to you. In some ways, this place is the most dangerous in the kingdom. Because here, you must deny vanity. The king wants to keep you a faithful disciple and follow his footsteps. But you have more potential than he will tell you. So, I have unlocked your abilities a little. There. You will no longer need to return to the workshop to choose a new mask. You can now change mask on the spot. Take up a mask and try borrowing into these two guardians to discover what you can do. Good. Now, borrow into the other. Good. Now, ascend the tower. So, tell me everything about yourself. Oh, of course, you're in one of the locals. Do not worry. They are empty automata, wood animated by the magic of this place. an ingenious way to allow you to access this realm when we thought it was cut off completely. Watch out for splinters, though. There you are.
Oh.
I can't see your true shape, but then I am not myself either. I am Neo, Mask of the Swamps. Mine is the first secret lore of Carnival. Be proud, love thyself, but do not allow vanity to take root, lest you lose yourself in the masquerade. You met my siblings and I, poor fragments. But here, at last, we can speak as we once were. We will not harm you, whatever the king has told you. Or maybe he prefers to keep us secret these days. He has tried to paint over all trace of his story. But even if you change a story's mask, the story stays the same, unlike people. You must remember a story you heard long ago in a distant place. A mask shop. Remember that you are not just a wooden dummy standing where he has put you. Remember, you are more than the mask. Now, get close to me and take off my mask. You will discover the truth.
So the master had his apprentice. The nameless boy grew up amid the paint pots and false faces of the mask shop. The boy learned fast, and he was gifted at the old techniques, tying feathers and mixing pigment and shaping wood. The master told the boy tales of the magical lands he had traveled through, searching for inspiration and components for his masks. Bright islands, deep forests, and high peaks. The boy dreamed of exploring these places for himself, discovering things the master had missed, and always his master promised. Soon, when you are ready. The old master taught him the three secret laws of Carnival. The three laws which keep those who would create new faces from becoming lost in masquerade. Firstly, you must love thyself and deny vanity. Second, know thyself to escape oblivion. And third, be open and tolerant to defy isolation. But it seemed that for every wondrous story of the Maskmaker's craft, there was another rule the boy had. Another rule that showed he was still not yet ready. The Maskmaker kept his secrets. He would not allow the boy to read his ancient blueprints handed down from Maskmaker to Maskmaker. And the boy could never enter the master's secret workshop where he created his finest masks. For it is dangerous to make new faces when you do not yet know your own. Frustrated with rules and riddles, the boy would run away, pockets full, searching for what lay beneath his own mask.
You begin to see. The mask begins to slip. Reach the other two towers. Speak to my siblings. Learn the truth, and do not trust the king. You may now Enter and leave the tower freely. Take off your mask and return to the workshop.
That is mountain craftsmanship, that is.
There you are. The first fragment of the Master's mask. Well done, apprentice. With the ancient mask as a base, we can create something grand and new together. Gather the fragments, and I will reward you when you finally come to my castle. Onwards!
Controller ran out of bed.
A mask does not conceal. It is an open window. It reveals. It transforms.
It was I just didn't remember.
How did you learn to do that? To switch masks outside the workshop? You are a quick study indeed. I can tell. I'm gonna have to keep my eye on you. The shepherds would graze their billy gruffs here. See, space for pasture is so limited that they would create these systems of bridges to rotate their flocks and allow the fields to regrow. Complicated business. Even a king must admit, they're rather cute. But this little thing seems to have lost his flock. Oh, these herders and their bridges. But beware, Billy Gruff's a bad-tempered beast. I can't say I've missed these creatures since the realm grew quiet. But, their soft, tough hair is a craftsman's treat. The shearing house. Here the herders sheared the hardy Billy Gruff hair for the weavers. Ugh, grimy, noisy business. But they wove everything from clothes to the kites up there in the sky. Listen to the creature bleeds. Find a way to bring it home, will you? A king must be able to harden his heart to his subject's feeling treaties. But still the bleating sound bothers me. Can't you bring it home?
Try and...
What's happening? Maybe this is not the shearing house, but the slaughterhouse. Oh, God, what did you do, apprentice?
I didn't want to do that.
Ah, freshly shorn and feeling the air. There, a lock of Billy Gruff hair. A fine design, crafted with Billy Gruff hair.
Once these shepherds would sing from mountaintop to mountaintop. See the decorations on its mask? It must have had the finest, clearest voice.
You are in the service of the mask. The riddle is to know what the mask expects from you at the moment you wear it.
There was a burial place for the Billy Gruffs here. These animals were highly beloved.
Honor my posture. Know thyself.
Billy Gruff horns, the last component we'll need. These old ones were used for strange rituals that are, thankfully, long past.
Fertility?
now I'm thinking of Futurama Psycho. Wait, human horn is being used as an aphrodisiac. But the human horn is actually the human nose.
Be careful. A mask always asks more questions than it answers.
Another fragment of the ancient master's mask is in that tower. Find it for me.
You need to synchronize with our statues.
Okay, so that's two.
What are you up to? I see. Well, fly, little kite. Once we have the three ancient master's mask pieces, they will form the base for a new grand royal mask for me. And perhaps one day for you. But tread carefully. Maybe a merciless trap lies somewhere.
You're only thinking that out because that's something you'd do. Excuse me. Well, sir.
So, you are here, at last. Face to face, or near enough. I am Sir, Mask of the Mountains. Mine is the second secret lore of Carnival.
Hello, sir.
Know thyself, and defy oblivion, lest you lose yourself in the masquerade. You have met my sibling, me, haven't you? Yes. Well, imagine being trapped in an old shop with him for longer than you can count, as the world moves on outside, and the shadows grow deeper. In any case, you have seen how the story began. Now it is time you learn how the beginning came to an end. Get close to me, take off my mask, and you will discover the truth.
Frustrated with rules and riddles, the boy would run away, pockets full, searching for what lay beneath his own mask. But the boy always returned to the shop, to the promise of learning the craft, the power to change and yet not be changed. So, you've returned once again, apprentice, the master would say. Did you find what you were looking for beneath your mask? Are you ready to create masks instead of hiding behind them? But the boy would say nothing. But try as he might, and change as he did, the boy and the old man were masked from each other. Not this year, not the next, as the boy grew up amid the masks and flattering aristocrats flocked to buy the master's wares. The boy struggled at his bench and wondered when he would be allowed to show himself. Until one night, when the boy noticed his master had left the workshop door ajar. And for the first time, the boy decided that he was ready.
You know a little more, but still have to learn to complete your apprenticeship. Go and meet our older sibling, Kabalash. His power is restored. And you can finally reach his tower. It's time to introduce yourself to the ritual.
Synchronize with our statues. So, you have met the king, or a shadow of him. You are his hands, his eyes in this world. But here, you are safe from him. Now, join me. Time is short. Once, this was a simple world, made up of simple cycles and created by ancient magic. A secret place of mindfulness, where Maskmaker's visions could blossom, where they could hone their craft on its simple wooden subject. The realm was passed down from master to apprentice for generations of mask makers until he escaped here, remade it for his own purpose, and called himself the king. It is good to see you, my friend. I am Kabalash, and mine is the third secret lore of Carnival. Be open, be tolerant, and defy isolation, lest you lose yourself in the masquerade. Together, we must liberate the king from this world. The only way is for you to heal the realm, complete the apprenticeship, and become the mask maker. Let's go deeper inside the mask and prepare you for the grand ritual a ritual the king has never seen. It is a little early for you, granted, but needs must.
Open yourself. Follow my gestures. Become them.
Ready to remember deeper. I warn you, they are not happy memories. That is why they burrow so deep. But you must understand before you can face the king. Take off my mask and you will discover the truth.
Until one night. Tired of tests, sick of the face in the mirror, the nameless boy found the way to the master's secret workshop. In he crept. He found the hidden blueprints. So, this is what the old man had been hiding. This is what the boy was unready for. Why, he had all the answers already. So many different faces to choose from that the old man had kept all to himself. But most important, he found the master's mask, handed down from maskmaker to maskmaker. He had already seen the old master wearing it in the shop. But how many secrets could one so simple old piece of wood hold? When he saw himself in the workshop's mirror, he was transported. Inside the master's mask, he discovered a whole world full of inspiration. The boy began to explore in secret and to believe he had discovered a power the old master had never found, a freedom he had always been denied. Was this where the boy could finally surpass the master? When the boy finally emerged, the light of dawn peeking through the shutters, the mask seemed different, reflecting the ambition and the desire of a young man who could become so much more than a simple apprentice. You have proven yourself, but you are still an apprentice. There can only be one mask maker in this realm. And the king is still on his throne. You must face him, and together you must face the truth. The Guardian still stands protecting the tower.
Welcome back, young initiate. You have new tools for your journey.
As you venture deeper into the mask realm, the workshop too is returning to life. New mask bases have appeared. And the mask maker's paintbrushes are waiting for you on the workbench so that you can paint with precision.
Young apprentices would spend months and years simply in carving base masks. But clearly, the workshop believes you are ready for more.
Or perhaps the realm has even less time than we thought.
Once we tried to reach the king, to speak through the guardians to him, but he retreated from us. He broke the bridges. He abandoned his subjects on islands and outcrops and shrank back to his castle. He does not even remember a world where he is not king. The mask is an imprint of the mind, of the emotions. Wear it, and it disguises you with truth.
Paint was always my favorite part.
The younger ones always prefer playing with colors, while older crafters find carving more refined.
A mask is a performance, and it expects you to play along. You must know what your mask needs you to be.
There have been great civilizations that rose without the wheel, but all cultures find ways to mask their members.
See, asymmetry in the mask design. In the mask realm, this is a sign of tolerance and openness to other cultures. Ah, fine mask, from the Ashkan wetlands. Wetlands once, but now a desert. The Guardian's mask has components from all across the realm. You'll have to travel to other lands to acquire what you need. Guardian has had a long vigil guarding this tower.
This is the Dapperberg.
Something is wrong with the groves. I can feel it.
I can smell it. But I cannot see it. Perhaps you can find why it grows. Did you see that? That damn bird? It stole the component we need. I should have eradicated them ages ago, if not for the feathers. The Red Heart nests deep within the forest. That's where they keep the stuff they steal. The mask of a wood gatherer. Highly skilled, they would go deep into the lower parts of the forests and swamps, seeking only ancient wood that the forest was finished with. These villages... We're getting to the root of the problem here. This is the beating heart of the parasitic fungus. From here it spread to the swamp and was reaching its tendrils towards further lands. Finally, we can eradicate it.
A bird hunter. Now we're getting somewhere. These would hunt redheart nests for feathers and sometimes eggs, until the heart of the parasite completely blocked the way.
What's the time?
I'm just gonna be fine. Oh, what to do? 1 o'clock.
Our guardian still stands sentinel over the mines. Don't let its unfriendly expression put you off.
The mines. The mines of Moria.
Being a mask maker is not about making masks for yourself, believe me, apprentice. But by making masks for others, you can find their truths, and perhaps catch a glimpse of some of your own.
The Blue Shard Mines. How many hours I spent down there when I first came to the Mask Realm. Delving ever deeper for ever rarer gems. But be careful. Even a king treads carefully here. Decorations on these houses, all inspired by the mine workings. It seems that they are related to the way they were taking their shifts. Looks like the gate of a great treasure house, doesn't it? See the great lock on the gate? I knew the correct code from when the mine was still exploited, and now I don't anymore. But I'm sure you will work it out. I never had a good memory for those things, so... Open sesame! Oh, smell that! The smell of rock dust and the deep earth, and... Pachydiscus fossils are a common decoration for miners down here, but this one is a keeper. I've not been here in... well, it's been a long time. When I first came to my kingdom, I spent hours down in the deepest mines, seeking the finest gems to make the richest of masks. There's a cold and a dark down there unlike anywhere else, and I forgot myself for a time. Can you see the blue light? That is our goal, where blue blood gems were mined. But it seems the cart system is out of order. The stoker who kept the furnace ignited.
Extraordinary designs, even down here in the dark. And they also offer a great protection against the heat from the furnace.
Masks are simple. They express their emotions directly, unlike humans.
Thank you.
This is where the tree tappers worked, harvesting the trees. Sap from the treacle leaf tree. This is precious stuff. Drips slowly and painstakingly for years, like tears of blood.
Okay, I'm gonna leave it there. My head is starting to hurt with this headset. Oh. I'm getting a bit tired. Yeah, I'd say I've made some pretty good progress. Oh.